years. So it refers to, well, the frame is the frame of through the camera lens, or the frame. Well, the frame is what goes around the picture that makes the picture be what it is. I mean, in order to have a picture, you have to have a frame. So. And given what we just said about photographs and filmic images changing their meaning through time, photographs are time frames. They frame time.
Because she looks a lot like Marilyn Monroe, but she's not. She has the same pout, a similar pout, and maybe the same lipstick. But I don't know who she was. Some unknown sex goddess. Or maybe known. Maybe I'm just ignorant. Oh boy. This one's obvious. Warmonger. The question is, I don't know, maybe you can tell from the wrinkles on his neck how many wars he's been through. Looks to me like World War I and World War II at least. You know whose side he was on? U.S. I don't know if you can tell who he was from the way his hand is positioned under his neck like this. Could be he just has a sore throat. It could be that he just needs a secret. I don't know. And his button says, think about it, and then it says help in the middle, and it says the state that he comes from, but I'm not going to tell you the state that he came from, and don't even try a close-up, it won't help you. It's written very small. I wonder if he regrets, now that he's dead, having worn that button, because it's pretty ignorant, let me tell you. He's got a three-piece suit on. It looks kind of English to me, but I bet you anything this guy is an academic. But I can tell, looking up close, the texture of the tie doesn't match the texture of the shirt, so I'll bet he's an academic, but I don't really know. Let alone the colors, which you can't see from this black and white. I can't see it either, by the way. Now, I couldn't choose between this one and this one because This one makes it interracial, which it deserves to be, of course. This picture's pretty funny, you know. I'll tell the audience.
See, I want to make images. I like to make images. And if I become too obsessed with keeping the images and looking at them, I won't be able to make them anymore. I have to put them away somewhere. I mean, I still love them. I can still pull them out and feel something for them, but usually they weigh against me. I wish that they were out of my apartment and that I had new ones.
Seconds, minutes, hours, days, months, hands, eyes, lips, stones, cathedrals, grass, candles, reflections, children, birds, shadows. There's a moment of not knowing who you are. Gray, dirty morning. City streets, motion with nowhere to go. Newspaper headline, some atrocity, coffee, stale smell of eggs and cigarettes. There is the river, the sky, the cry of gulls. World shot in black and white. Screech of tires, footsteps, honking horns, outside world trying to get in, inside world trying to get out. There is a desire that can only be expressed by watching something fly, or sail, or skate, or sink.
I had slipped the lifeline that morning and was drowning in you again. But you were in love with an angel from Jersey, so he tagged along on the shoot that day. From the beginning, our work on the film had been a struggle between two desires, yours and mine, and our object was never the same. Looking at the sequence now, I see only two things that trace my desire that day. I am the one who decided to stop and peer up at the cathedral, marveling that there's one left unfinished in the world. And all the heavenly blue morning glories that swarmed across the fire escapes of Manhattan that sad summer were mine.
Pre-Raphaelites is a group of painters forming a brotherhood to counter everything that they had seen in the academy. They called themselves consciously the Pre-Raphaelites in an effort to express their admiration for the artist who came before the age of Raphael. Basically, they felt those artists had a kind of sincerity in their art, a simplicity and a sincerity. The Pre-Raphaelites were very concerned with what they saw as like genuine ideas, sincere art, meaningful art. Well, one thing that strikes us, I think, instantly when we look at a Pre-Raphaelite painting is the fact that they aren't simple. It's the fact they're loaded with detail. Most of them are almost microscopic in their detail. And part of this detail is observable scientific fact. And it will be things like plants along a waterbed and every kind of grass, every kind of flower delineated down to how many leaves. But the nature was often a very elaborate and carefully drawn background for a moral story, for something involving the human figure. Most of the figure groupings are male and female relationship oriented. A lot of them deal with love, morality, things like that. The men in these works are frequently sort of a type. Robust, lusty, frequently. The women take on a character that soon becomes very closely associated with the Pre-Raphaelites. A woman that is frequently lovesick, and frequently that is physically visible in a kind of distant stare.
The yellow leaf is falling towards an ambush of gold. Shadows are resting across the lawn. The chairs in the garden tell a story of relationships come and gone. Everywhere you look, there's silence, some story. Suddenly, you're caught. You find yourself staring. You realize you're floating, suspended in the act of gazing, looking at the falling of a leaf, the glare of the sun, the shadows that surround you. For a long time, you cannot shake the feeling of being suspended in space as you look and look and look. What do these objects feel? What do they think? Do they see you? Do they know who you are? Are they aware of your desire? If you didn't see them, would they be there at all?
This studio filled with glamorous merchandise, fabulous and exciting bonus prizes, including a warm and wonderful full-length chinchilla coat. For the picture-perfect home, a $37,000 designer showcase. And here's a great-looking, great-handling automobile, the Buick Riata. Plus thousands of dollars in cash, over $197,000 just waiting to be won on Wheel of Fortune. And now, here's your host, Pat Sajak.
Thank you very much, and welcome to our little program here.
It was her desire to have me film their daily ritual. Every day, at the end of the day, they would lie close to one another and whisper to each other their thoughts and fears, their joys and sorrows. They would touch and kiss and caress one another and heal each other's wounds. They would tell each other stories and dreams, anecdotes and histories about themselves. What was my desire? My desire was to be free of time.
Can't sleep because of the rain. Lay back, turn out the lights. Watch my hands.
It isn't a very large pond. It's rather small. But then the duck is small.
Suddenly you will catch fire. Someone beautiful will kiss you. Something in the shape of a cloud will come into your room, into your nest.
The day I went to the to that park on the west side on the river was not a day in which I was feeling the strength of solitude.
Watch my hands. Follow my hands. Take my hands.
It almost seems as though it wasn't real. As though I were in a dream or in one of those TV movies.
A reindeer will dance in the streets. A candle will burn in the window. Morning glories will spin around your room. Watch my hands. Look at my eyes. Then close your eyes and let go.
And it swirls around and swirls around, and it thinks, I'm this and I'm that, and I can do this and I can do that.
Take a deep breath.
Yes.
Take
yes.
A deep breath.
No. No, no, yes.
Take a deep breath.
Swim. Swim around inside your bowl, little fish. And dream of the sea. I'm swimming too. I'm dreaming. Pick a dream. Pick a dream with me, little fish. Crystal freedom.
On Christmas Day, I took the subway to Coney Island. My lover was there, and he had given me some I Ching coins. The I Ching is all based on chance. It's what they call synchronicity. You throw the coins, and then you draw some lines, and then you read what you've thrown from a book. Well, I threw the coins, and I was amazed to find that I had thrown the exact same combination of lines that I had thrown just 1 year earlier, prior to beginning time frames. Well, I mean, this was amazing. I mean, the odds of that happening are incredible. And, I mean, it was, to me, that was like, I was like tears were welling in my eyes, and I hugged told my lover about it, and we hugged, and then we just let go of that moment and went back home, but... anyway, that was that Christmas day many years ago.
December 31st. This December day is a reflecting pool into which I step, serene and confident, fearing nothing, knowing that I will continue to find my way through this world, through echoes and re-echoes of thoughts, feelings, and memories, making and breaking resolutions as I go step by step from one moment in time to another.